started, sir.
Hello, this is Dr. D.V. Chavan from Dragon Deep Water Divining Center. We are using the electrical earth resistivity meter test for the survey of the geological survey beside that EMF meter and the dowsing rod and compass. So now I am going to use how to use the L-shaped rod. How does the L-shaped rod work? Earth is a magnetic field where the every 8 feet magnetic gates are running, which frequency is 7.89 hertz. Wherever underground, there is a moment of water is there, deposit of mineral and cavity, the frequency goes very high. So based on that, we are doing. Now, we have already done the survey. This property is about 10 meters by 25 meters. And we have put some red flags. These are the inlet. And between two red flags, the channel, which is almost about 20 feet channel is there. And in that channel, from the north to my right is the north, to my left is the south. From the south, five channels are meeting, which is the smaller one. And from the right side, from the north, another five channels are meeting. And we are getting three inlet junction points. Out of these three junction points, we are getting the center one, the better point. Okay, that point, we are getting the rock up to 60 to 70 feet. We are getting the rock. And then the water in table is from 700 to 900 feet. 700 feet water will start. Maximum we are getting is 2 to 3.5 inch. Okay. Water will start somewhere between 650 to 700 feet. Now I will show you a demonstration how this works. First we have checked the wet channel. This is the wet channel. This channel size dimension is almost 20 feet. Okay. From here, this is the direction of the sea. All this yellow pipe we are given, this is the line channel. And this water is passing from here. This is the, again, this is the channel where number stream is coming from the south side. And this stream is coming from the north side. This stream is coming from the north. All this lining which we have put here the boundary, and this is the inlet. And this water is coming from here and moving this side. And this here, one more inlet is there. This inlet is a larger inlet. The line junction is there with a huge inlet. This is the inlet which is there, water is coming here. It is almost about 10 feet is there, and again from the south also the 10 feet inlet is coming. And all this yellow line is the boundary line of the channel. And this is the exactly this is the center point of the water. To 60 feet junction is there. Then again, further we have got a point. Here one more point we have got it, which is a small stream. The junction is almost about 6 to 7 feet. The first junction, which is the number one point, we have got about 16 feet. Second junction, we have got about 15 feet. And third is about 7 feet. The first junction, second junction water is a very good second point. And this water is coming here, which is going outgoing towards the, again, this is the west and this is north towards the northwest. How the water movement is there, this I am going to show you. This water movement underground, which is happening based on the fracture, based on the tectonic plate. In India, the tectonic plate, it is moving from the southwest to northeast 37 degree. In that there are certain fractures happen, we'll get that water. And again, where we are having a good aquifer, where wet water accumulated, we try to get the point where there is a good fracture is there. When we are doing the dowsing, we are programming on that. Now we are just going. Now we are just following the water stream. How the water is following? The water is, now here turn is there, there is a good water. Now again we are going further. There is an excellent water. This is the best point which we have selected. Here, it is rotating by own. Then again, we are going here. There is a third point is there. Okay, this water is also good. Then the water flow, it has gone toward the northwest. This stream, which is here meeting, 10 streams are meeting in this property within 25 meters by the 10 meters and giving three junctions are happening, and this biggest stream, 10 meters feet stream, it is going further down and it is moving to the river. This is like a nala. In that nala, the small channels are meeting. If suppose you are drilling here in between, you may get the good water. But what happens in the under the earth is some floor. Under the earth also there are a lot of huge boulders are there. If that will collapse, if this line will get choked. Now at this point there are three inlets are there. Water is coming from this side, water is coming from this. This is the outlet. So out of these three, suppose in this point 10 psi pressure is there. Okay. That second point the pressure is a 5 psi, and third point the pressure is a 8 psi, and this pressure is a 4 psi. So what happened? If this line is blocked, whatever out of these three, the lower pressure is there, whereas 5 psi pressure is there, water will start going that direction. Okay, so at least you get water. Look, if you are drilling here, if it is a block, water will stop. If you are drilling here, at least these two streams will continue. So you have to see from the different aspects. Our success rate is almost 96 to 97. Based on the dowser we have checked, based on the magnetic reading we have checked, this is the number one point, I am getting the deflection of compass about 8 degrees. Number two point, I am getting the deflection of compass about 4 degrees. And number three, we are not getting any deflection. All this marking which you have made, these are the inlets. This is the number one inlet where water is coming from the north to south and meeting this bigger junction. And here the second point which is coming towards the south side and meeting this junction. This is the third point which is coming from the south to north and meeting this larger stream. This is the fourth point which is coming from north to south meeting the bigger stream. This is the fifth point coming from the north. This point dimension is the smaller channel which is coming. It is hardly about 3 feet channel. This is also a smaller channel which is about 3 feet channel coming from the south. This point is a slightly larger problem. This is the 7th channel coming from the north, which is about 4 feet. And soon from this channel, which is coming from north to south, this is also 4 to 5 feet. Then last channel, this is the channel, which is about 6 feet channel coming from north side. And this channel is also a smaller channel coming from the south to north and going the water outlet. Again, drilling the bore is not very important. Drilling on the right day, if you are doing on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, yield will be better. Try to avoid Sunday, Tuesday and Saturday. Or if you are doing on Saturday, Sunday or Tuesday, go for the Moon Hora, Guru Hora, Buddha Hora or Shukra Hora. Again, at the time of drilling, the alignment of the rig should be checked with the vertical speed travel meter. Soon the alignment goes 1 degree wrong. So chances of going, when it reaches up to 700 feet, the point will go almost about 10 to 15 feet away. So you use a vertical spirit level meter. Because this inbuilt spirit level, which is a round one, zero accuracy is not so much air bubble. In the vertical spirit level meter, after putting that both the adjacent the bead, both two studs are there, clean the studs, use the new bead, spirit level meter. If the spirit level meter is worn out, then again there will be error will be there. The wrapper should be removed. Before putting on the stud, it should be clean before putting the speed level meter. Second point, below the jack, you put the wooden block, bigger one, 6 feet thick, 2 feet by 3 feet, and all the four jacks. Take the load, entire load, one by one jack, so that whatever soil has to submerge, it will submerge, further it will not submerge. Because over the rear side, where they are putting the pipe, the bead, that side weight will jump more. Suppose this is the point which we are drilling it here. This is the point which we are drilling at present. By putting the rig, you will put the rig east to west or west to east. Suppose by chance we are put from the east to west, and the rig front point, because of the load, this portion has gone down. When this portion will gone down, heat will go toward the east. This is the inlet channel, water can come. If suppose this portion will go down, chances of going front portion going down is less. Chances of going deep portion down is much more. If we go toward the outlet, to the outlet point. So better to push it than when you are putting the rig to west to east. You, this portion being a more load, this portion will go down, the beat will go toward the outlet point. Because all the entire water accumulated in going there. Second part, every 100 meters, 100 feet, check the leveling meter. If the level meter is wrong, half a degree, 1 degree, you can correct. If the level gone wrong, about 3 degree or 4 degree, if you are correcting, it will go almost 20 to 30 feet away. And if your correction is done, then the beat will get break. These people, they say, no, if it go, the alignment goes wrong, beat will break. No, if alignment slowly, if you get it 3 degree or 4 degree wrong, it will go in that particular angle. But suddenly, if your alignment change, beat will break. So alignment part, and if it is raining, so at least 1 week, if it is raining, you should not do the drilling part. And if it is raining, you should stop. If it is on the road, hard surface, concrete surface, you can do. But that should be also strong enough. During the rain, soil may go, and where they did the refilling of the soil, there also you have to be very careful before the drilling. And before drilling, you have to ensure that the rig, which is you are using it, the compressor should be very strong. And that is generally we found that Cannon borewell, their maintenance is very good, the compressors are strong. As the rig is new, if it is the auto loading is there, then what happened in the auto loading, the entire load of those pipe it come on the vehicle only. It is getting balanced. When we are loading manually, the entire load comes in the front. So auto load is always better, which will go fast and this thing. If any doubt, any question you are having, you can call to Dr. D.V. Chauhan, Dragon Water Divining, Deep Water Divining Center, Geomancy Center of Excellence, Bangalore. And for the more detail, you can call on this address. Okay, my mobile number is 93412-62874. We are located at Bangalore, Jayanagar 4 T Block, providing these services past 40 years. L-shaped dowsing rod is one of the methods which we are using. Beside that, we will upload the other method also one by one. How to use the V-shaped branch, how to use it, how to use the EMF meter, how to use the compass, all those things we go one by one, we will upload. If any this clip video shooting I'm uploading on the YouTube. If you have got any doubt, any remarks, you put it. If you want any further information or training, we are conducting training classes also on this. You can come, we can train you, and you can work as a water diviner professor. And second part, which is very important, the coconut which we are doing the testing, it will lift you on the smaller stream. How the coconut raise? Because the static electricity come hand, knowingly and unknowingly it is moving because of that. So there you will not form the stream. Even if you are driven on the single stream, which is a 4 feet, you are getting water. But at any reason, if you block because the holder, the entire water stream will block. Even you are drilling here, you are getting water. But if this will block, they will not. Even though it is a mainstream, the water will start diverting to the other side. Thank you very much. God bless you.